In this video, I will go over the differences between the SSL 4000E, the SSL 4000G, and the brand new SSL 9000J plugins by Brainworks, so you can choose which ones are best for you. Brainworks has now three consoles emulated in the form of a plugin: the SSL 4000E, the SSL 4000G, and the SSL 9000J. My BX Console SSL 9000J review covers a lot of the functions they all three share, so check that one out first if you want. For the comparison in this video, I only use this plugin on every channel in a mix. The TMT channel settings were the same for every plugin, so increasing numbers for every channel. The balance of the tracks is the same every time, and I did not change anything, and I inserted the SSL plugins in default. And I exported these mixes every time with a different SSL emulation, so three mixes. You can download these exported mixes from my website, just follow the link in the description below. Before we start, please like this video and subscribe to this channel, a channel to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. These are the random files, and let's A/B them. There's also a track without any plugins. As you can see, here's the no plugins track, here's the SSL 4000E, here's the SSL 4000G, and here's the SSL 9000J. I will just play the track and switch between the different emulations. Maybe you have noticed, but the plugins do not output at the same level. The SSL 4000E is the loudest, followed by the SSL 9000J and then the SSL 4000G. So that volume difference can be deceiving. There's a difference of 1.2 dB between the SSL 4000E and the SSL 4000G in my mixdowns, and that is something you will notice and translate into the loudest is the best. So I have mixdowns, but then with corrected output volume. Let's check them out. Here are the files corrected by volume. The 4000E got decreased by 0.6 dB and the 4000G got raised by 0.6 dB and the 9000J is the same. Okay, let's do the same again. I will play the track and I will switch between the different plugins. One way to hear a difference between them is to do a phase reverse trick. Then, for instance, you take the SSL 4000E track and the original track, and then you phase reverse one of them. And then you are left with the difference between the tracks. Let's do that right now. Let's phase reverse the no plugins track. Let's do it over here. Phase reverse. And now I will play the no plugins track and the SSL 4000E track, and what you hear is the difference between the two tracks. Let's do the same with the 4000G. And the 9000J. And you can hear on all of them that the bass stands out. I found out that the input filters on all of these plugins change the phase. The 4000E and the 4000G by default have the filters enabled and the 9000J doesn't. So this caused a difference by comparing them, and I turned them off on all of them. I have one comparison left, that is all plugins with the filters disabled in comparison to the original file. Let's check it out. So we're gonna do exactly the same, but now the filters are disabled. So the conclusion of this is that they all, without any tweaks, do something with the sound. If they did nothing right out of the box, we would have perfect phase cancellation and thus silence. Let's go through the mixes one last time. If you compare these mixes, the 4000E has more going on in the 200Hz area. You can hear that in the bass, it sounds a bit more consistent here. And the 4000E has the most punch. The 4000G has more in the 10K area going on, and you can hear that in the hi-hat. It sounds like a bell curve. It also sounds a bit bigger than the 4000E. And the 9000J is more dynamic than the 4000E and the 4000G. You notice that in the last notes of the bass guitar. And in the higher frequencies, it has more going on. It sounds like a shelf and it has more air. All of these differences are pretty small though. What you hear is the result of 9 instances used on every mixdown. But they all add something pleasing to the sound in comparison to the version with no plugins. Here are the plugins. This is the SSL 4000E, this is the SSL 4000G, and this is the SSL 9000J. Let's go over the functionality differences. The E and the G channel have the 2-release function, which is an additional release knob to avoid pumping on, for instance, acoustic tracks. And the 4000E and G also have the possibility to switch between the E and G series dynamics, which have a slightly different character. The 9000J only has the 9000J dynamics, but it has a hold function in the gate which the 4000 series do not have. And the 4000E and G also have an additional hysteresis control, which is a dedicated gate close threshold. In the EQ sections you have all sorts of differences between the plugins. The 4000E comes with the ability to switch between black and brown EQ of an SSL 4000, like this. See? Brown and black. The black EQ is more rock and roll and the brown is more smoother. On the 4000G, the EQ switch switches between the pink and the orange EQ types, which have different tonalities. The orange also has the abilities to switch the shells into bell curves. The pink EQ has the additional features of the divided by 3 and the multiply by 3 frequency settings on the mid bands. So pink has a broader frequency range than compared to the orange setting. The 9000J shells have all the functions of the 4000G, so switchable shelf filters to bell and back, and the divided by 3 and the multiplied by 3 frequency settings. And the EQ of the 9000J can be switched for tonality to the classic 2-for-2 card type. Let's go over the sound of these plugins and select a few tracks. Here's the bass. Let's enable all plugins. 1, 2, 3. Let's enable the input to full on all plugins. The THD to max. THD is total harmonic distortion, by the way. And let's do some compressing. Let's start out with the 4000E, bypass the other two. The 4000E has a default of 3.5 to 1, and let's do the same on the 9000J. Let's set the threshold to -11.4. Also with this one. And let's compare now. Let's start with the 4000E. Let's do the G. And the J. Let's switch between them. With these settings, the 4000E has the most weight and the 9000J is more focused. The 4000G leaves more of the attacks intact. This is all with the same settings, so you hear a difference in behavior. Let's go for snare drum now. Here I want to check out some EQ on the low end and the gate. I'll boost 200Hz on all three EQs to keep the comparison fair, since that is the lowest the 4000E can do on the midband, and it will add a Q of 0.8 and boost it by 9 dB. Let's start out with the E channel. Let's go to G. And finally the 9000J. Again, the 4000E has the most weight and sounds thickest. The 9000J is more transparent and the 4000G is somewhere in the middle of those two. Of course, if you play around with the settings, they will get closer in sound. Now let's add a gate. Let's set the threshold to minus 9 dB, the release to 0.35 seconds and the range to minus 32 dB. Okay, let's check them out. Let's start out with the J. Of course, the hold function of the 9000J gives it more flexibility, but you can always play around with the hysteresis settings of the 4000E and G. Let's do some mid-range EQ comparison, but we do that with the Skank track. Okay, let's do some EQ. It will be 11.5 dB boost at 2.5 kHz with a Q of 0.7. The 4000 series have a max Q of 0.5 and the 9000J has a max Q of 0.7. That's why I chose the 0.7 of the 9000J series. Let's compare, let's start with the J. The 9000J seems to let the transients come through better and sounds more open and silky. The 4000E has a bit more of a notch and is more aggressive on both types of EQ. The 4000G sounds more like the 9000J in this regard. So you could hear, all plugins have their own characteristics. If you have to choose two, I would choose the 9000J and the 4000E, since these two sound the most different from each other, so you have more sound choices. So let's summarize. In my opinion, the 4000E is the most rock, and the 9000J is the most open and silky, and the 4000G sits in the middle of those two. But all three sound good, will definitely add a pleasing sound, have musical EQs, great compressors, and a lot of functionality to improve any mix. Thank you for watching this video. You can find my full review of the BX Console SSL 9000J here. If you want to compare the mixes with the plugins yourself, download the files from my website. The link is in the description below. Please subscribe to my channel and I'll see you next time. Bye!